عبادك الأيام فتى وتنحي.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to take a فائدة benefit. We're going to be taking the فائدة the benefit from the كتاب of Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله فوائد الفوائد in which he wrote رحمه الله which is known as كتاب الفوائد. Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله he said page 255 he said أسباب العصيان. What are the causes of sinning? What are the causes of sinning? And this is a very powerful benefit that the Shaykh rahimahullah mentions. He says, أصول المعاصي, the foundation of sins, كلها, all of it, كبيرها, the greatest of it, وصغارها, and that which is small, ثلاثة. The foundation of sins, that which is large and that which is small, all of it, they revolve around these three. They revolve around these three. The first one is تعلق القلب بغير الله. The heart being attached to other than Allah. The heart being attached to other than Allah. The second one is وطاعة القوة الغضبية. Obeying your anger, the power of anger, obeying your anger. And the third one is والقوة الشهوانية, obeying your power of desires. Those are the three. The first one is attaching your heart to other than Allah. The second one is obeying your anger. The third one is obeying your desires. The first one is called shirk. The second one is called dhulm, oppression. And the third one is called fawahish. So when a person attaches his heart to other than Allah, the Shaykh said, وَهِيَ الشِّرْكُ it is shirk. If the person obeys their anger, it is dhulm, oppression they fall into. They oppress others. And when the person obeys their desires, they fall into fahisha. Now the Shaykh is going to explain it to us very well. He says, فَغَايَةُ التَّعَلُّقِ بِغَيْرِ اللَّهِ الشِّرْكُ وَأَنْ يُدْعَ مَعَهُ إِلَٰهٌ آخَرَ. The final ending of attaching your heart to other than Allah is shirk. And the person, it leads him to calling to other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, calling unto Allah other than him subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or calling unto a god other than him. What about the person who obeys his anger? The Shaykh said, وَغَايَةُ طَاعَةِ الْقُوَّةِ. When the person obeys his ability, it leads him to الْغَضَبِيَّةُ الْقَتْلِ, killing somebody. And the third one, he said, وَغَايَةُ طَاعَةِ الْقُوَّةِ الشَّيْطَانِيَّةِ. The person obeying their desires will finally lead them to الزِّنَا. Zina. وَلِهَذَا and those three جَمَعَ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ بَيْنَ الثَّلَاثَةِ فِي قَوْلِهِ. Allah combined all these three which are known as أُصُولُ الْمَعَاصِي, the foundation of sins. Allah combined all three of them in one verse. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَدْعُونَ مَعَ اللَّهِ إِلَهًا آخَرَ. The first one. And they are, when Allah spoke about the characteristics of عباد الرحمن, the servants who are righteous, the first one he started in this verse of their characteristics was what? والذين, they are those. لا يدعون مع الله إلها آخر. They don't call unto other than Allah. ولا يقتلون, and they do not kill النفس التي حرم الله, the soul in which Allah prohibited from them killing it. ولا يزنون, and they don't commit zina. You see, then the Shaykh went on to saying, المعاصي يدعو بعضها إلى بعض. Sins call onto one another. One sin calls onto another sin, and another sin calls onto another sin. And so the Shaykh is trying to show that each of these three will call onto one another. He says, فالشرك شرك يدعو إلى الظلم والفواحش. By falling into shirk, it will lead you to oppress, and it will also lead you to committing zina and impermissible acts. Just like كما أن الإخلاص, just like sincerity and the tawheed, يصرفها عن صاحبه, it will divert a person from it. By coming with ikhlas and a tawheed, it will divert you from ظلم and fahisha. By coming with shirk, it will lead you to ظلم and fahisha. And he said, Allah mentions that in the Quran. He says, كَذَلِكَ and like that, لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَى. And like that, we diverted. السُّوء, what does السُّوء mean? Ibn al-Qayyim says, الْعِشْقُ, love, desires. وَالْفَحْشَى means zina. We diverted Yusuf alayhi salam from this. Two things that Allah mentioned that he diverted Yusuf from. السُّوءَ, which is عِشْق. عِشْق is, it's not just a normal love. عِشْق means it's a bad love when you want to commit zina. وَالْفَحْشَاء, which is zina. إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ. The reason is because he was from our sincere servants. Because he had tawheed in, Allah diverted him from what? The other sins. The Shaykh says, وَكَذَلِكَ الظُّلْمُ يَدْعُ إِلَى الشِّرْكِ وَالْفَحِشَةِ. The same way oppression, it calls to shirk and it calls to fahisha. فَإِنَّ الشِّرْكَ أَظْلَمُ الظُّلْمِ. Because shirk is the greatest oppression. كَمَا أَنَّ أَعْدَلَ الْعَدْلِ التَّوْحِيدِ. Just like the greatest justice is tawheed. فَالْعَدْلُ قَرِينُ التَّوْحِيدِ. Justice is always with a tawheed. وَالظُّلْمُ قَرِينُ الشِّرْكِ. And oppression is with shirk. ولهذا يجمع الله يجمع سبحانه بينهما, and Allah combines between the two. He always combines between tawheed and justice, and shirk and oppression. He's going to give you evidence, as he said in Surah Al Imran, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم قائما بالقسط, with justice. لا إله إلا هو بالقسط. لا إله إلا هو بالقسط. After that, Allah mentions. The second ayah is, إِنَّ الشِّرْكَ لَظُلْمٌ عَظِيمٌ. Shirk is the greatest oppression. وَالْفَاحِشَةُ تَدْعُو إِلَى الشِّرْكِ وَالظُّلْمِ. The third one, which was fahisha, which is zina, and other than it, it calls on to shirk and it calls on to oppression. وَلَا سِيَّمَا especially إِذَا قَوِيَتْ إِرَادَتُهَا وَلَمْ تَحْسُلْ إِلَّا بِنَوْعٍ مِنَ الظُّلْمِ وَالْاِسْتِعَانَةِ بِالسِّحْرِ وَالشَّيْطَانِ. Especially if that desire has become strong. وَلَمْ تَحْسُلْ إِلَّا بِنَوْعٍ مِنَ الظُّلْمِ. And a person is unable to gain the fulfilling of their desire except by oppressing, they will oppress. A person's desire has become strong, and there's no other way where they can fulfill their desires unless they have to force a person into zina and rape them, they will do it. So فَاحِشَ will lead you to oppression and shirk. How will it? A man will rape just because of what? Because of his shahwa that's in him. So he does dhulm. And he also might even fall into shirk by doing what? By actually placing magic over this person. You see, وَالِاسْتِعَانَةُ بِالسِّحْرِ وَالشَّيْطَانِ. So they all call onto one another. وَقَدْ جَمَعَ سُبْحَانَهُ بَيْنَ الزِّنَا وَالشِّرْكِ. Allah combined between zina and shirk. أعوذ بالله. Shirk and zina have been mentioned together, because there's a relation between the two. And Allah said, الزاني لا ينكح إلا زانية أو مشركة, والزانية لا ينكحها إلا زان أو مشرك, وحرم ذلك على المؤمنين. Finally, the Shaykh mentions ضعف توحيد القلب. When the tawheed in your heart becomes weak, فهذه الثلاثة, these three, which are what? The three that we mentioned are الشرك والظلم والفواحش. He said, these three, when your tawheed is weak, يَجُرُّ بَعْضُهَا إِلَى بَعْضٍ, they start to pull each other. One starts to pull you to the other. Each one starts to push you to the other one. وَيَأْمُرُ بَعْضُهَا بِبَعْضٍ, and each one starts to order you the other one. وَلِهَذَا كُلَّمَا كَانَ الْقَلْبُ أَضْعَفَ تَوْحِيدًا وَأَعْظَمَ شِرْكًا كَانَ أَكْثَرَ فَاحِشَةً وَأَعْظَمَ تَعَلُّقًا بِالصُّورَةِ وَعِشْقًا لَهَا. Allahu Akbar. And he said, every time that the heart is weak in terms of its tawheed, and shirk is greater in it, the greater a person's zina and the fahisha is greater, and the more that a person, his heart is connected to his lust and his desires. And the Shaykh says, وَالنَّذِيرُ هَذَا قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. And this is basically in the verse of Allah in which he says, فَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّن شَيْءٍ فَمَتَاعُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشَ وَإِذَا مَا غَضِبُوا هُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. The Shaykh said, فَأَخْبَرَ Allah informed us in this ayah, أَنَّ مَا عِنْدَهُ خَيْرٌ. That which is with Allah is great and good. لِمَنْ آمَنَ, but it is for the one who believes. وَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَيْهِ, and he relies on him. وَهَذَا هُوَ التَّوْحِيدُ, and that is Tawheed. After that, what did he say? He said, وَالَّذِينَ يَجْتَنِبُونَ كَبَائِرَ الْإِثْمِ وَالْفَوَاحِشَ. And they are those who stay away from the major sins. فَهَذَا اجْتِنَابُ دَاعِيَةِ الْغَضَبِ الشَّهْوَانِيَةِ. That is when the person leaves off the call to fulfilling their desires. And then after that he said, وَإِذَا غَضِبُوا هُمْ يَغْفِرُونَ. And then when they become angry, they forgive. فَهَذَا مُخَالِفَةُ لِقُوَّةِ الْغَضَبِيَةِ. And that is when the person is in opposition towards their anger issues. فَجَمَعَ بَيْنَ التَّوْحِيدِ. And he said, in this ayah, Allah combined between Tawheed, وَالْعِفَّةِ, chastity, وَالْعَدْلِ, and justice. And those are أَلَّتِي هِيَ جِمَاعُ الْخَيْرِ كُلِّهِ. And that is the thing that brings all form of good. And they are the opposite, all of them are the opposite of what? The three that we mentioned. At-Tawheed is the opposite of Shirk. Iffa is the opposite of Fahisha. And Al-Adl is the opposite of Dhulm. And Wallahi, this is a fa'ida azima in which Shaykh al-Islam Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah rahimahullah, he brought out, and we will conclude there for today. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.